In this video, we're going to go over how to write the prime factorization of a number. So first of all, we have to remember, you know, the prime numbers. So remember those: 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, etc. So remember prime number, no number goes into it except 1 and itself. So those are the prime numbers. So I can, you know, take and multiply some prime numbers together to get any number, right? So let's say I took the number 2 times 3 times 3 times 7, for instance, and if I just multiply those numbers together, what do we get here? We have like 6 times 21, that's 126. Actually, this is the prime factorization of 126, because it's a way of writing 126 as the product, means multiplying, product of only prime numbers. All right, so our goal is to be given a number and to figure out what its prime factorization is. Okay, let's do some simple ones to begin with. What if I wanted to prime factor 10? I think, well, what prime numbers would I multiply together to get 10? And hopefully that's not too difficult, just 2 times 5. Now, what if I were going to do 20? All right, what prime numbers would you multiply to get 20? Well, this one, there's not just 2 prime numbers that you multiply to get 20. So I'll show you one way of getting the answer. You think of any 2 numbers that multiply out to be 20, since 20 is not prime. For instance, 2 times 10. And then, you look at the numbers you have so far. If it's prime, you just write it down again. So I'm saying this is equal to, and then if it's not prime, I break it down. So 10 could be written as 2 times 5, and now that is the prime factorization of 20. So that's one way of doing it. Let's try another one. How about if I were to do, let's say, 36? Pick any 2 numbers that multiply out to be 36. Now, there are lots of different possibilities, so you might get a different answer than me when you start off, but at the end we should get the prime factorization the same. So go ahead and put it on pause and see if you could do the same technique and end up with the same factorization I get. All right, how about if I just think of that as 6 times 6? But neither of these are prime, so I have to break them down further. So 6, the first 6 could be written as 2 times 3, and the second 6 could be written as 2 times 3. And that's the prime factorization. Now, usually, you write the prime factorization either with the numbers going from smallest to largest or the other way around, and you might also use exponents. So I usually like to write it to smallest, from smallest to largest. So I would put 2 times 2 times 3 times 3, or you could put 2 squared times 3 squared. So either of these is correct. This is the way you might write it if you're going to use exponents. But all 3 of these are correct. There's 4 factors in the prime factorization of 36. There's a 2, another 2, a 3, and a 3 multiplied together equals 36. All right, let's take 150 and try it using this method. So you try to think of any numbers, any 2 numbers that multiply out to be 150. So, now I see a 10 times 15, so I'm going to start off with that. And then these I break down. 10 is the same thing as 2 times 5. And 15 is the same thing as 3 times 5. And then I like to write it so the smallest number comes first. Or you could write 2 times 3 times 5 squared. Okay, both of those are correct ways of writing it. Actually, all 3 of these ways are correct, as long as all the numbers are prime. And to check your answer, you just multiply those numbers together. You could get out a calculator and make sure you really do get 150. So the prime factorization, it's the product of what numbers multiply out together to give that given number. Now, another way to do the find the prime factorization is by using what's called a factor tree. And this just requires a little bit less writing. So if we start with the number 150 again, What you do is it's sort of like a tree going upside down. That's the root. Normally trees, go up, right? We're going to just do the branches going downward. So again, I think of any two numbers that multiply out to be 150. So I could put 10 times 15 again, or I could put 2 times 75. I could put any two numbers that multiply out to be 150. And then I look at each number I get off that branch, and if it's prime, I circle it. That means I don't need to break it down any further. Now, 75 is not prime, so I go further. And I think any two numbers that multiply out to be 75. And hopefully you recognize that 5 goes into it, so you could do it 5 times something. Or I kind of think of 75 as 3 times 25. All right, so we do this again. 3 is prime, so I get to circle it. 25 is not, so I break it down to 5 times 5. I circled them because both of those are prime. And that's not how you leave your answer, though, looking like a tree. You want to write your answer. You see, you've circled four things, so you're going to write those four numbers multiplied together. So 150 is 2 times 3 times 5 times 5, or you could write it as 2 times 3 times 5 squared. Either of these works. Now, notice there's a lot of ways you might end up getting a lot of paths you might take to get the answer of 2 times 3 times 5 squared, depending on how you break up the very first part of the problems, 10 times 15, etc. And also, you do still have to know what your prime numbers is so that you know, like 25 is not prime. You have to know that 5 times 5 goes into it. And remember the little hint I gave you. If you're trying to find any number all the way up to 120, just check to make sure 2, 3, 5, or 7 go into it. If those four numbers don't go into it, it's not going to be prime. All right, 182. Well, it's even, so now I could break that down. Let's do this with a factor tree. So you think of any number that goes into 182. Since it's even, I'm going to try 2. And that'll be 2 times 91. And does 2 go into, I'm sorry, is 2 prime? Yes. 91, is that prime? Well, let's check. 2 doesn't go into it. Does 3 go into it? No. Remember, you just add the digits, see if 3 goes into it. Does 5 go into it? No, because it doesn't end in 0 or 5. Does 7 go into it? Yes. Do you remember that divisibility rule for 7? You just cross off the last digit and double it, and then subtract it from what's left, and then 7 goes into 7. So you know what? 91 is not prime. It's 7 times something. And now you have to actually do the long division, and 7 goes into 91 13 times. All right, 7's prime, so I get to circle it. 13's prime, so I get to circle it. So 182 is 2 times 7 times 13. All right, how about for 392? Well, this is kind of a large number, so I'm going to use a factor tree over here, putting it over. And some people don't know where to start. If it's even, always start with the number 2 and see if it goes into it. So that number I could tell right away goes into it, and then I have to do my dividing by 2, I get 196. So 2's prime, I go over here. And I keep dividing it by 2 as often as I can. So if you have a large number, you're not sure where to start, just keep dividing by 2 until you can't anymore. So 2 goes into it because it's even, and I get 98, and that's prime. And let's see, it's still even, so I could divide by 2 it one more time. And then we're down to our times tables here. For 49, that shouldn't be so difficult. 7 times 7, both prime. So the prime factorization is, and now when you do it this way, you're going to get the numbers in order, smallest to largest. 2 times 2 times 2 times 7 times 7 is the prime factorization for 392. And if you get out a calculator and check it, you'll get it. Some people like doing it this way using a sort of upside down division method. I'm just going to show you what that would look like. So we would start with 392, and you think of your primes, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, etc. And you start off with the first prime. And if it goes into it, you write it on the left side. So 2 goes into it, and then you just do long division, and you get 196. Then you see if the same number goes into it again. So you try 2 again, and it does. I have 98. I do it again until I can't divide by 2 anymore. Right. Now at this point, you look at the next prime and see if it goes into it. Does 3 go into it? No. You look at the next prime, 5. Does it go into it? No. Next prime is 7. And you're done when the last number is a prime number. So again, same answer written that way, or 2 cubed times 7 squared. So a few ways to get the prime factorization of a number.